The iGaze Games website has been created to work with a wide range of iGaze cameras, when both the camera and website have been set up correctly to work together. In this video, we will look at how the Tobii i13 or i16 can be used to play games on iGazeGames.com using the different modes available in its TD control software. The website has been designed to work with your iGaze camera when you are using your iGaze camera to control the mouse cursor position and a left click. There are two control schemes built into the website that you can choose between. There is Classic, which uses large on-screen buttons to control actions in both the 2D and 3D games. And there is Precise, which is more direct and uses either smaller on-screen buttons in the 2D games or uses the mouse cursor to steer or aim in the 3D games. Classic is a good place to start for many players and can be used with all of the different mouse control modes in TD control. However, some players may like the more direct controls the Precise option offers, but not all modes in TD control will work with it. The three modes are Default, Continuous, and Repeat Click. We will go through the three different modes in TD control and show how they can be used to play with the two different control schemes on the iGaze Games website. When using TD control, the trace circle will follow your gaze. When you momentarily fixate somewhere on screen in the default mode, the activator will appear. If you look at this activator button and select it, you will open the interaction menu. From here, you can choose to left click at this location, or you can choose to adjust target if you want to enlarge an area first, before then clicking on a target within it. You can also choose to use continuous mode if you want to speed up this process by using the trace to select a location, and then a left click option will appear in place of the activator icon. You could look at this left click icon to make a click at the location you have just selected. You can access continuous mode by looking at the bottom of your screen and selecting the button on the right. You may access it from the mode menu also at this location if you have more than one option for modes set up. In continuous mode, you can also choose to adjust target to enlarge an area first before clicking. This will remain on for subsequent selections until you turn it off. Here we are now using the classic control scheme on the website in some of the 2D games. We select a button to choose a piece, another button to choose where it moves to, and a third button to make the move. Here we are now using the precise control scheme, and we can directly choose pieces on the board and then choose where to move them to. Here is an example of using the classic control scheme in the 3D games where we are using the on-screen buttons to steer and drive in Open Drive. And here we are using the on-screen buttons to move the camera to aim and hit in Gazy Golf. If using either of these two modes in 2D control, you would not need to use the optional inbuilt dwell on the site when setting up your controls on the Setup Wizard or Controls menu. Both of these modes in 2D control can also be used with the precise control scheme for many of the games. However, they will not work with the 3D games, such as Gazy Golf or Open Drive using precise mode, so choose Classic when playing these games. This can be done in the Controls menu, accessed either from the main menu or via the pause menu during the game. Some games also have a shortcut in the top left of the screen to switch between the two. If you would like to play the 3D games more directly by using 2D control in the precise control scheme, you will need to use the repeat click option. This will enable you to have constant control of the mouse cursor on screen, which the vehicle follows in Open Drive, and the camera follows to aim in Gazy Golf. To access the repeated click mode in 2D control, you will first need to add it to the mode menu, as it is not there by default. To do this, look or move the mouse to the bottom of the screen, then select the button with the three dots. Next, select the settings cog and go right to open the customization menu. Select the customize the modes menu and add an option below the continuous mode icon. Select repeat click and then select add. Exit the menu, and when you now look to the bottom of the screen and select the modes menu icon, the repeat click icon will be there. If using the repeat click mode on the iGaze Games website, you can also use the inbuilt dwell, which uses a dwell animation which is centralized on the on-screen buttons, which some might find helpful to select a target more easily. The inbuilt dwell time can be adjusted in the iGaze options on the website or in the Setup Wizard. You can also choose whether you are able to select a button repeatedly without looking away and back to a button, and you can also choose the dwell appearance. Here is an example of using 2D Control's repeat click mode, but with the left click turned off and using the inbuilt dwell in iGaze Games to make selections on the site. Here we are now using the classic controls in some of the 2D games. We select a button to choose a piece, another button to choose where it moves to, and a third button to make the move. Here we are now using the precise control scheme, and we can directly choose pieces on the board and choose where to move them to. Here is an example of using the classic controls in the 3D games using the on-screen buttons to steer and drive in Open Drive. And to move the camera to aim in Gazy Golf. And here we are using the precise control scheme, and the vehicles follow the mouse cursor. And here, the camera follows the mouse cursor to aim in Gazy Golf 2. We hope that this video has been useful in setting up your Tobii i13 or i16 and its 2D control software with the iGaze Games website to suit you. To try the games yourself and play for free, visit www.igazegames.com.